Good evening, Divya. How are you?
Sir, I am good, sir.
Good. You are attending this mock from where?
Sir, presently I'm in Delhi.
Where? Delhi.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So can you please introduce yourself to the board? A brief introduction about yourself.
Yes, sir. Sir, I am from Kanpur, Uttar Pradesh. I have completed my schooling from Navodaya Vidyalaya. I am a textile engineer and PhD in strategic alliances. I have also worked for 3 years in textile industry. And so last year I have joined Indian Railway Traffic Services. Presently I am on leave.
Yes. So this is your last attempt or?
So is this
your last attempt now?
So this is my third attempt, sir, not last attempt.
Third attempt. Hopefully, this should be the last and you will make it.
So it's a competitive game. We'll see what happens. I am preparing.
Life is competitive. It's like that only.
So the deserving should get the services.
So Kanpur, you were referring to like, can you give me something for historical importance of Kanpur?
Yes, sir.
Echo is there. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. I can hear you clearly.
Kanpur, any historical importance of the city? Kanpur?
Yes, sir.
Can you give me some perspective on the city?
Yes, sir. The origins lie in the name of Hindu Raja of Sachandi dynasty who established it, but it gained the prominence during British era and especially after the mutiny of 1857. They converted it into a very stronghold with cantonment, and then the textile industry boomed here along with the leather industry to fulfill the military needs. And so from there on, it became a major industrial hub. And today it is also an economic hub, and a dedicated freight corridor will pass through it along with the defense corridor.
Something happened during the Second World War which brought a lot of industry to Kanpur. I think I've got field gun factories there, government parachute factories there. So many factories are there. So what was that which triggered it? It was all in Kolkata. It shifted from there to Kanpur. What was the reason for that? Shifting all those defense industries during the World War, Second World War?
Yes, sir. Yeah, it was expected that an attack may come from the eastern side. So Ordnance Factory Board, one of the factories, is established in Kanpur to fulfill the artillery requirement and some tank spare requirement.
It was the Japanese nailing almost Kolkata. So
yes,
British
sir.
Were afraid that it was Kolkata, all these factories were shifted that side.
Yes, sir.
So any famous personality in India now from Kanpur? Very high position now? Kanpur?
From the Kanpur Dehat region, we have our president.
Thank you. Mr. Sarangi, sir? Over to Mr. Sarangi. Sarangi, sir, is for you, sir.
Sir, please unmute your mic, sir. Sir, please unmute your mic, sir. Sir, your mic is muted.
Chandra, you can just call and tell.
Yes, sir.
Or we can go to Ganpati, sir, first.
Okay, am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
I am audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very nice. So, Divya.
Yes, sir.
I find from your biodata you have taken philosophy optional.
Sorry, sir, I could not hear the last part.
You have taken philosophy optional.
Yes, sir.
How and why?
So I just love the subject. When I was in the fray to choose one subject, I looked into the syllabus, and today I find it has made my civil services preparation journey really joyful and very meaningful. And to a large extent, sir, it has transformed me. So in the hindsight, it was a very wonderful choice. It has given me wonderful ideas to think about and helps me all the time.
Okay, okay. Existence precedes essence. Can you explain the statement?
The existentialist, like Heidegger, Sartre, they talked about that existence comes prior to the essence. That human beings, no matter how much we strive for self-essentialism, but the fact that the way we interpret our past and foresee our future is nothing but a string of choices. So we have to make our being by acting into this world. And therefore, sir, concept of freedom becomes very important in existentialism.
Okay, existence precedes essence. How do you explain it very simply, in a very simple language?
Sir, I have to exist first to have a core essence in me.
The individual precedes the group, isn't it?
Yes, sir. It could be interpreted in this sense also.
Okay, okay. Very nice, very nice. How does Kant answer the fundamental question? Kant says that understanding makes nature out of things which it doesn't make. How do you explain this?
Sir, previously, before the Kant, we always thought that mind has to reach to the nature to understand it. But he completely reversed this model. And he said that things have to come pass through our mind and various categories to make sense. For example, we are not space in space and time, but space and time are within us. Every observation that we make is always stamped, spaced as well as timed.
What is thing in itself?
Sir, it is the nomina, which is unknown and unknowable. That when we look at the things, it is always conditioned with our subjectivity. Wherever a thing in itself is a pure entity, which we are completely unable to understand.
Okay, 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 okay. Pakistan has got how many provinces?
Sir, I can start recounting the Balochistan province, Sindh province, and Northwest Frontier province.
What is the name? What is the new name of Northwest Frontier province?
Sir, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, I think it is.
Yes, yes, name. Yes. And Punjab. These four were there.
Yes.
Now Gilgit-Baltistan is also added.
So yes, sir, it is a temporary status though. They cannot...
The fifth province that they have declared.
Yes,
so what? How is India related? That's my question. My question is, how is India related?
Sir, it is a completely matter of concern for us. It passes through our sovereign region and it is a matter of territorial integrity and sovereignty for us.
Supposing that would have been a part of India, what would have been the advantage to India?
Sir,
Gilgit-Baltistan.
Yes, sir.
What Pakistan was calling it? What name did they give it earlier?
Sir, Azad Pakistan. I think that.
No, it was called Northern Areas.
Northern Areas.
Northern Areas is different from Azad Kashmir. So Northern Areas. So now, if that really belongs to India, because sir, that was a part of that was a part of undivided Jammu and Kashmir earlier.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So that they have occupied and that has become a part of Pakistan now. Supposing that would have been a part of India, that India would have that in Jammu and Kashmir. What is the advantage?
Sir, our connectivity with the Central Asian region, the Tajikistan belt, we could have approached easily to go into the Afghanistan.
Afghanistan, because we have a border with Afghanistan, technically, yes, 150 kilometers.
So we have overseas Air Force base also in the Tajikistan, sir. It would have been strategically very important to connect with the Central Asia also. And sir, also security point of view, because it lies along the tri-junction of the China, India and Pakistan.
Why Central Asia is important to India?
Sir, Siachen Glacier.
Central India is important to Asia. Why? Important to India. Why?
Sir, Central Asia or Central India, sir?
Central Asia. You said that you would have gone to Central Asia from Afghanistan. Why is Central Asia important to India?
Sir, Central Asia is our extended neighborhood. We have civilizational ties. And sir, apart from this, it's an energy basket. The Kazakhstan has immense uranium resources. Tajikistan has gas reserves for with itself. And we enjoy a goodwill there.
It is very energy rich. Yes, so there is an electricity grid, which is called CASA, Central Asia, South Asia. So it is extremely energy rich. That area is energy rich, both uranium and other gas, etc.
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So that would have benefited India like anything. But
yes.
But what has Pakistan done?
So the area comes within their side of the border on the left side of the POK. So now CPEC passes through it, which is China administered. So it is a contested region as of now.
What is their border agreement in 1963? 2nd March 1963, Pakistan and China have entered into border transfer agreement. What is that?
So I am forgetting exactly the name. It is on the western side of Siachen.
It is called Sakaskam Valley.
Yes, sir. Sakaskam Valley, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir. That is the name.
But what happened to that? What happened to Sakaskam Valley?
Sir, it was given to China.
Around 5,100 square kilometers. That is very important.
Yes, sir. It is very, very
And all the other three small valleys were also given. So, but that is the biggest amongst them. And there is a clause in that agreement that clause recognizes that this is a disputed area. And later on, when the dispute is settled, then China will negotiate with the concerned authorities. That is, there is a clause 5 or 6 of that agreement that says clearly that this is a disputed area.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if Gilgit-Baltistan would have been part of India, China and Pakistan would have no connectivity. The Karakoram Highway, etc., would not have been there.
Yes, sir. It connects the Xinjiang. It is the connecting link between the China and the Pakistan.
And now CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor.
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay. Sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Over to Ganpati sir.
Yeah. Divya Mishra.
Mr. Ganpati.
Ms. Divya Mishra, you are from Uttar Pradesh, right?
So yes, sir.
What are the Dhamik Stupa? What are the speciality on that?
Sir, Dhamik Stupa. Sir, I'm forgetting in which era it was built, but I remember that during the visit of one of the Mughal emperors, its revival had happened. So my knowledge is limited. I remember it was in news, and it is a very important heritage of our country.
Okay. Have you heard about this Disaster Management Act 2005?
Yes, sir.
What is that?
So it provides a legislative institutional framework for effective interstate and district coordination to handle the disaster related situations.
Okay. The government of India, they have announced that the paradigm shift after this disaster management bill passed. What is the paradigm shift?
So, to my mind, I think when we shifted from the reactive approach to more proactive preparedness based approach, where we had disaster response force, National Institute of Disaster Management, and district level mitigation funds, disaster management funds. So this created a space where disaster was put at the heart of our developmental policies following the Nagoya, I'm forgetting the name of the Japanese agreement that was there. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. And there is a Prime Minister's 10-point agenda. There is one point in that is related to women.
Yes,
what is
sir.
That? What is that?
So women should take the leadership role in the community's participation, and their feedback and their experiences should be incorporated, because they are the most vulnerable and worst affected sections of any disaster.
Okay. In recent days, you know, a lot of increasing disasters. There is one recent disaster called GLOF. What is that GLOF? GLOF, G-L-O-F, GLOF. What is that?
Sir, sorry, sir, I have not come across this. I need to educate myself about this disaster.
Recently, there was a GLOF in Uttarakhand. A lot of people died. Okay. It's a global outburst. Okay. And you are basically a textile engineer, right?
Yes, sir.
So what is the geotextile? Where they use?
So it is a technical textile and it is used to stabilize any structure. It could be the riverbanks or the areas around the sea to prevent the coastal erosion or to prevent the fragmentation of the soil beneath the roads. So we have the geotextile beneath the roads also these days. And also in the landslide related regions for the wall retainers. So for these purposes, it is used.
Okay, my last question. So what is your opinion on women's safety in Uttar Pradesh?
So I think women's safety by no account is what it should be in my state. And the crime rate is really very high, conviction rate is low.
Okay, good.
Mr. Ram?
Thank you, sir. Good evening, Divya Mishra.
Good evening, sir.
How do we decide one thing as right or other thing is wrong?
So please give me a moment.
Okay.
So we decide it on the basis of the means followed and the ends pursued.
How are our values formed within us?
So these are formed based on our social conditioning, the family systems in which we are born, our schooling, our experiences throughout our lives, the kind of things we read and how much consistent they are with what we believe. So the core peripheral beliefs, which are well tested, become our values.
Do our civil service need philosophers?
Sir, absolutely, sir. We have a philosophy, Indian and Western philosophers in our GS4 ethics paper. UPSC has given a lot of importance to the philosophy because it is not just a subject. It is a pursuit of wisdom and what is right and wrong.
Please comment three sentences. Everything happens for the best.
So it shows a positive outlook that no matter what actions have been done, something good will come out of it. But it is also overconfident statement because it makes us immune from the consequences of our mistakes.
Best painter or best artist cannot instruct the plants how to blossom.
So we cannot be deterministic in nature. The nature has its own eternal laws through which it operates. And the architect and the painter, whatever they paint, its beauty depends on the viewer, which may vary. Okay.
Last question. Philosophy is a waste of time. When we read philosophy, we get some quotes for our conversation. That's all.
So it could be one of the opinion when the time of crisis comes, we do need more practical point of views. But sir, philosophy is also an investment of time. Otherwise, we would not have come across values like democracy, justice, and truth.
All the best. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Harikiran.
Yeah. Mishra, you have selected textile technology in your BTech, and then now you are in railway traffic service, and now you are aiming for the civil services. How is the journey from textile technology to railway traffic services and to the competition for civil services?
Journey has been so far very rewarding. It has had a complete transforming effect on me. I feel that I have found, it has changed me. From sentimental, I have become more sensitive. I have become more silent and observant. And it has given me a lot of humility that there is so many things that I do not know.
Okay, what is this global corporate tax?
So, it is in the talks now because of base erosion and profit shifting and offshoring of the profits to low tax jurisdiction. Now in the G7 meet also, my various countries are coming up to settle it at 15% at the minimum level.
You are in Indian Railways, and there is this concept called train collision avoidance system, which a lot of importance is given. What is this about?
So it is a technology in making. It is under testing by the Konkan Railways. And I do not know exactly the mechanics involved in it. So I have to study about it.
You mentioned in your DAF that reflecting ideas of, you'll know, Harari. Is politics about truth?
Sir, everything is about truth. But when politics starts gaining power by distorting the truth, then that becomes a problem.
Okay. What is this Build Back Better theme summit? What is it about?
So it is a Japanese concept of post-disaster resilience, that whatever infrastructure, physical or social, we build, it should be better, more disaster resilient and disaster proof.
Why is it in use now?
Sir, the current context, I might not be completely sure, but I think because of the recent cyclones on both our coast, and because us being a very cyclone, very disaster prone country, it is very essential that we keep the building back better in our developmental agenda.
Suppose you were an officer made in charge of any agitation that is happening on the road. People are complaining that they are not getting electricity in a particular area, and despite repeated their approaches to the government officers, their issue is not resolved and they have come onto the roads. So what would be your approach to resolve the same?
Sir, if I am in the capacity of the as an administrator, then my first response will be to go on the spot, negotiate with them, and to see that it does not explode into a law and order situation. And for that, I will try to arrange the police force there. And because their concern is genuine, sir, I think it is the foremost responsibility of any responsible governance to address that issue with their leaders. So am I audible?
Yeah, you can please proceed.
So I was saying that because their concern is genuine, so I will try to negotiate and talk and persuade with their leaders about the grievances, and I will try to fast track the grievance redressal. And because to avoid that, it should not, that it does not implode into a law and order situation, I will try to have sufficient number of police personnel on the ground with me.
And despite your negotiations, because they couldn't get an instant solution, they are not able to move out of that place and the road gets blocked. This is a practical situation. How do you handle it?
Sir, road blockage is also, in this context, Supreme Court has said that in such situation, we can divert them to another pre-designated area. So I will try to make sure that the agitation, because it's their constitutional right, goes on, but in some other place without blockage of the road.
Okay. Have you heard about satellite phones?
Yes, sir.
How do you get a license or permission for it?
Sir, I might be hazarding a guess. I do not know. I never thought of this. I have to read about it.
Thank you, Mr. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ahmed.
Hello, Ms. Divya.
Yes, sir.
I have just two questions for you. As far as feminism in India is concerned, despite a lot many efforts over the past two decades, philosophically speaking, where do you think we have gone wrong as a country, as a nation?
So consciousness of feminism is on the rise, and I can see that within myself, as well as I have two brothers, so the way they treat and they behave. But when I look at the lower section of the society who are socioeconomically disadvantaged, and in the those where women are working, there is a lot of issue. There is a issue of institutional discrimination, coded insult, glass ceiling, double standards. So we have a long way to go.
Fair enough. Just one more question. Would you rather go for a revolution through 50% reservation for women in legislatures, or would you let time and evolution solve the problem that creates a better number of, more number and better quality women leaders?
Sir, I would go for a 50% reservation on every domain, on a horizontal basis, because we cannot wait for that long. If our country is to emerge as a powerful world leader, then 50% of the population cannot wait like that. It has to be fast-paced.
All right. Thank you, Mr.
Thank you, sir.
Divya, just adding to that, what is the gender mainstreaming?
Sir?
Gender mainstreaming?
Sir, putting the gender issue on all the aspects of our policy making, be it economic sphere, political sphere, social sphere, education, health, budgeting.
Mm-hmm. So there is gender mainstreaming. Are we practicing this in our country? In our policy formulation implementation, is it being followed?
So to a large extent, we are doing that. We have a gender budgeting. We have dedicated schemes for women. For example, in the Stand Up India scheme, almost 33% of the credit offtake is goes to the women. And so also in SHG movement, there is a large participation from the women. And if we start doing some affirmative action so that this becomes a more substantive justice rather than procedural, so we may have a better outlook for the women in India.
What is women empowerment?
Sir, empowerment enlarging, of women? Sir, enlarging the basket of choice for women.
Any example in India, like government of India or states, somebody doing?
Sir, we have Beti Pao, Beti Bachao scheme. It looks into the protection, survival, protection, education, sanitation. All the spheres of women.
Just last one, not the least. So many women candidates getting into IAS and mostly getting into IPS. Generally, very few IPS ladies will be there, but now you got around 30, 40 in every batch. So how will the service character change over a period of time, maybe 10 years from now? You got around 30-40% ladies in the IPS itself. IAS, of course, there were many were there, but IPS first time, so many ladies getting inducted. So how will the profile of the service change? What will be the impact on service delivery?
Sir, there will be a gender sensitization all across the levels of organization. And we need more, we will see more soft skilling, more child sensitive, gender sensitive approach. For example, in Uttar Pradesh, now there are pink booths, pink patrols, dedicated women self-help desk on each police station. So this helps women to come forward to report. And that is why we see the crime rate against women has actually increased in Uttar Pradesh. Partly this is also because reporting has gone up. It shows more public faith.
Thank you. We come to the feedback. Sarangi, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. The answers are very nice. I'm very happy. But treat
the neighbors of India also know about them very well, like Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Nepal, etc., etc., know about them very well, because Pakistan is especially very important.
Yes, sir.
Punjab was going to be divided into Punjab and South Punjab. Bahawalpur, Junabi, Punjab, BJP. So, but that did not materialize. Okay. So, know about those places so that it has effect both on internal politics of India and also Indian foreign policy. So, that's very important. But one of the deepest questions asked to you is, how do you decide right and wrong? So, it is one of the deepest questions ever asked ever in philosophy.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Right and wrong are called moral categories.
Yes, sir.
So, you gave one answer, that's all right. But if you employ a harmful means and get your end, will you call it right? You
so
gave an answer
right.
That
way, dropping of nuclear bomb on Nagasaki and Hiroshima would have been called right, but it's not right, sir.
Okay. So, another answer could be, you could refer to Kant's categorical imperative and get away with an answer.
Yes.
I do something and I will, that thing becomes a universal law.
Yes.
And society can exist, then that becomes right.
Yes.
Okay, that is another, that is a student of technical philosophy student's answer. That could be categorical imperative could provide you some regarding that. But
yes, sir.
Okay, I am audible.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Divya, I want to see your name somewhere at the top in the list, final list.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Divya, I have one small suggestion actually. What is that? When I ask about this Dhamik Stuba, it's very important one actually. There, it's in Sarnath, and Gautama Buddha first start Dharma over there.
Yes.
So historically, it's very, very important one. And another one suggestion is I could see your answers only one line or it will be very lengthy. So if you could extend actually, since some of the answers I could see you can extend some more, and a few answers maybe it's very lengthy, you may try to cut it to the point. That's all. Thank you, sir.
It's fine, ma. All the best.
Thank you, sir. Sir, did I approach the three statements correctly?
There is no correct or wrong. All these things are based on our values.
Yes, sir.
All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Harikiran.
Yeah, just one or two suggestions to add. Mishra, when the panel is asking question, you should wait till the question completes. A few times I saw your answer starts before the question gets completed. And somewhere when answering the question, towards the end of it, the approach becomes very slightly casual. For example, when Sar asked about the Dhamik Stupa, you casually mentioned that my knowledge in this is very limited and these things, maybe it could be slightly fine-tuned. Otherwise, body language is good, you're well-prepared. Especially some of the answers you gave with conviction, like you said, more public faith we get when more women come into the services. That is really good. This approach is good. Maybe you should have some kind of listening patience till the panel completes the question. Otherwise, when you don't have an answer, you can skip it. Like I said about satellite phones, just to keep you out of your comfort zone, and you skipped it nice. But whereas this Build Back Better, it is the G7 summit that is happening now. So it's the theme of the summit and you completely entered into a different arena. It's okay. You can slightly improve on it. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Mr. Ramit?
Ms. Divya, how much did you score last year?
Sir, last year it was 176.
I think you definitely deserve much more than that. I wish you all the very best. You have a really good way of handling the panel members as well. Just be what you are. You'll definitely score much better. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Divya, I think I agree with Hari. Actually, just give a little bit of time, reflect and give the answers. And when you don't know that, you can smile and, sorry, sir, I don't know. I don't have the answer. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
You don't take any guess and all. If they compel you to take a guess, you can take a guess. It's not required and all. So be a little more diplomatic and all. And you will do well. I hope, I think all the panelists, you should get around 200 at least. That level of preparation is already there. And just brush up a little bit more. So yes. When is the interview?
Sir, it is on the 27th of August.
27th of August. A lot of time is there. Almost more than 2 months. So prepare small notes. You're already in service. And one thing I want to do, what is the scope, ATS and IPS?
Sorry, I could not
both
hear.
The services, Indian Railway Traffic Service.
I could not hear what you just said. There was some internet connection.
Physical standards, which are common for the IPS and IRTS.
Yes, sir.
What is that?
So I think it is about the eyesight and the certain other.
So you can't be color. You can't be color blind.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is
same standard is followed for these two services. They don't follow for any other service, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Just adding that. Thank you very much. All the best.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good day. Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.